Greetings of the day. On behalf of Department of Mechanical Engineering, College of Engineering, Pune, I welcome you all for academic year 2021 and I wish you all the best for the first semester. The name of subject is Analysis and Synthesis of Mechanism, which is a specialized subject included in departmental level electives. The course code is ME DE 17005. Let me start with my introduction. My name is Abhishek Patange. I'm working as an assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering at College of Engineering, Pune, and also I'm pursuing my PhD in the domain of application of machine learning for fault diagnosis from VIT Vellore. I completed my master's in mechanical design engineering from Savitribai Phule Pune University and B.Tech in Mechanical Engineering from College of Engineering, Pune. The area of expertise includes mechatronics, industrial fluid power, that is hydraulics and pneumatics, numerical methods, theory of machines, analysis and synthesis of mechanisms, health monitoring and predictive analytics, data acquisition and instrumentation, and application of machine learning for mechanical engineers. Along with that, I always adopt case study based learning, research based or project based learning in my academics or teaching learning process. The research related activities can be found with the help of the links which are given here: my LinkedIn profile, the Scopus profile, Google Scholar profile, and ResearchGate profile is given here. So you can visit these profiles to know the research related activities which I have done in past and current ongoing going activities. Now I would like to brief upon my publications. The first publication is related to development of machine health monitoring system. Basically, the FFT analyzer, that is fast Fourier transform analyzers, which are used for vibration analysis of different machine components, are of very high cost, near about 10 lakhs or 15 lakh rupees, which may not be affordable to small scale industries or some of the academic institutions. So this research advocated the development of machine health monitoring system, basically using open source hardware, software, and it was integrated with the Python to analyze the health of or condition of any kind of machine fault, so that this can be act as a low cost solution to the vibration analyzer or any kind of analysis of machine component using variables like temperature, noise, power consumption, and so on. This was published in journal named as Advances in Intelligent and Intelligent Systems and Computing, plus published by Springer Publication, and it is indexed by Scopus. The second publication is about development of 12-channel temperature acquisition system for heat exchanger analysis using MAC6675 module, which is nothing but a signal conditioning module which is required for K-type thermocouples, because it includes cold junction compensation, conversion of analog signal to digital signal, and so on. And it was integrated with Arduino to acquire the reading in MS Excel. So the signal from Arduino to MS Excel was communicated through the software, which is called as PLXDAQ, which is freely available on Google. So this was also proposed as a low cost data acquisition system for a heat exchanger analysis to one of the research scholar, Sandeep Nalavade. The name of journal is Lecture Notes of Mechanical Engineering, which is also published by Springer and indexed by Scopus. Third publication is related to my PhD work, which is milling cutter condition monitoring using machine learning approach. Basically, the milling cutter inserts, which are carbide coated inserts, fails due to change in speed feed depth of cut or like various conditions. So to monitor the failure of this particular inserts, the vibration during the interface of cutting tool and workpiece were acquired, and then it was modeled using statistical analysis and machine learning approach to propose a classification and prediction of particular fault of the inserts. this was presented in the conference held by IIT Madras in 2019 and published in the Journal of Material Science and Proceeding Material Science and Engineering by IOP Publications, that is Institute of Physics Publications UK, and it is indexed by Web of Science and Scopus. Fourth publication is related to improving of program outcome attainments using project based analysis or project based learning implemented for UG course mechatronics, where many projects were allotted to the students in group of 3 or 4, and the project based learning approach was compared with the traditional teaching learning, and it was found that project based learning has really good potential according to the traditional method. Hence the outcome of this activity was there was lot of improvement in program outcome attainments. This was published in Journal of Engineering Education and Transformation, which is also indexed by Scopus. The fifth publication is about the development of mechanism for high precision scanning, which was system identification of XY flexural mechanism by double parallelogram manipulator for high precision scanning. So basically it includes flexural mechanism, which is a part of compliant mechanism, where there are no separate joints like traditional 4-bar mechanism or cylinder crank mechanism, but the mechanism is consists of a monolithic it is basically a monolithic mechanism. That means it is does not have any separate joints. That complete mechanism will be made up of a single structure, and the joints are made of the flexible materials, or we can say some kind of flexure, so that permits the motion between two links. So this was from the domain of compliant and flexural mechanism, which is also published in lecture notes in electrical engineering by Springer and Scopus by Index. Then the next publication is about tire pressure monitoring of two wheeler using machine learning approach, where the vibrations of wheel hub were acquired to supervise the condition of tire pressure, and it was modeled using machine learning approach. This was sent to journal name Structural Durability and Health Monitoring, which is indexed by Scopus, and which is accepted for the publication and will be published soon. Then the next paper is about a contribution of my student named Aditi Rahegaonkar, which is development of a fluid flow monitoring system using flow sensor and Arduino interface, which was presented in one of the conference held by Weltech University Chennai, and Aditi bagged first prize as best paper award for this particular research, where this is also a kind of proposal of a low cost data acquisition system used for the flow monitoring of any kind of pump or any kind of thermal devices. This was also published in lecture notes in mechanical. This is about to publish in lecture notes in mechanical engineering by Springer and Scopus by indexed by Scopus. Then the eighth publication is also related to my PhD, where machine learning approach and different classifiers are used to monitor the health of multi-point tool inserts on vertical machining centers. This is sent to journal by elsewhere, which is the name of journal is Measurements, which is indexed by Scopus and SCI. SCI is Science Citation Index, and it was uploaded. The status of this publication on 27th May is under review. Then publication 9, 10th and 11th are also related to my PhD, which basically includes the various classifiers and various data analytic techniques which are applied for the same research, and which is sent to various journals which are Scopus and SCI index. One of the significant journal is Manufacturing Letters and Structural Health Monitoring, with very good impact factor as 4.8, which are also under review, and some of the decisions are pending. So we hope we'll get the decision very soon. Then last two publications are related to the machine learning approach itself, but these are contributed by my students. The 12th publication, you can see my student So now the last two publications which are contributed majorly by my students named Naman Bajaj, Apurva Khairnar and Disha Kotecha. The 12th publication, you can see it is application of machine learning for tool condition monitoring in turning. Similar to milling, we have tried to model the same condition monitoring technique for single point cutting tool in turning using various classifiers and to predict the condition of that particular single point cutting tool insert. This was sent to Journal of Prognostics and Health Monitoring, Health Management, and which is under review. And the last paper recently, Mr. Naman Bajaj, my student, and Disha Kotecha, she is from ENTC COIP. They have worked on the statistical analysis of national and municipal level corporation for the database of COVID-19 cases in India. And they have done some regression analysis to predict the, to examine the nature of graph and the prediction of the cases. This is completed but yet to submit, and which is very good contribution by my students using numerical method approach. So such kind of many publications are in progress which are contributed by me, my students, by mentors from different colleges and are yet to publish. So if you are ready to contribute with me, you are always welcome and most welcome for this activity. So now let us move for the analysis and synthesis of mechanism subject. The teaching scheme is theory, there will be 4 hours theory lecture per week with 1 hour for each lecture. The examination scheme includes the attendance and quiz for 10 marks. Project-based learning and evaluation will be for 40 marks and NSEM examination will be for 50 marks. So what is project-based learning and evaluation? So in the elective subject of this analysis and synthesis of mechanism, the task of modeling and fabrication of mechanism was given to students in the group of 4. I'm talking about the last semester's work. However, near about 12 models of different mechanisms are used in lab for demonstration, which was made by student and outcome of this particular activity. And it was found that students' involvement was raised to such a high level that now they are thinking for future modification for that particular project or filing a patent or converting that prototype into commercial product and so on. So the presentation of this activity are recorded and some of the videos are uploaded on YouTube for helping engineering aspirants to understand their real-time applications. Some of the links are shown here. The toe-operated drum pedal model was made by Rohan Deshpande, Kaushal Kulkarni, Naman Bajaj and Riya Jadhav. The link is given here. The another project was VATS linkage by Apurva Khairnar, Rushikesh Khade, Aditi Rayagaonkar and Sana Sheikh. The link is also given here. And the another project was related to synthesis and analysis of ellipse drawing mechanism by Devendra, Shirish and Vinayak. And the last is synthesis of 4-bar mechanism for loading and unloading of boxes by Nikhil Neha and Saili. Basically these 4 types are, these 4 types describes the various approaches of analyzing and synthesizing the mechanisms. That's why these have been uploaded on YouTube. You can refer these videos for your reference. Now let us go for the syllabus of this particular subject. Unit 1 includes the basic concepts which includes fundamentals of mechanism, kinematic pairs, degrees of freedom, how to calculate degrees of freedom for planar mechanism and for spatial mechanisms, kinematic analysis of planar mechanisms, review of graphical and analytical methods to find out velocity and acceleration of particular link. And then analysis of complex mechanism by the normal acceleration is also included. Second unit includes the graphical synthesis for planar mechanisms with some of the accuracy points given by Chebyshev spacing, types of errors which comes into the picture while analyzing the mechanism and how to reduce those errors will be going to study. Then the graphical synthesis for function generation, rigid body guidance with 2, 3 and 4 accuracy points using the relative pole method is included in graphical synthesis. Then the third unit is related to analytical synthesis of 4-bar mechanism and also a slider tank mechanism. using a Prudenstein equation synthesis for 3, 4 and 5 precision points, or it is called an accuracy points. The fourth unit is related to coupler curves. Basically, coupler curve is nothing but a curve which is traced by a coupler. And how to synthesize and analyze this such kind of curves, we are going to study using Robert Chebyshev theorem, using double point and symmetry approach. The fifth unit is related to spatial mechanisms and robotics. Basically, the first four unit includes the study of different synthesis and analysis of approaches for planar mechanism, but fifth unit is related to mechanisms which are working in a space. So that is why it is called as spatial mechanisms, which includes the how to calculate mobility for such kind of mechanism, because it is working in all six in all three planes. Then we'll be dealing with how to describe the motion of spatial mechanisms, their kinematic analysis and synthesis, and some of the robotic manipulators application we are going to study. And the last part is very interesting and real time oriented, which includes computer programming for the applications of preparing the program for angular velocity of various links of four bar mechanism, and then how to find out velocity and acceleration of coupler points. The various points within the coupler will be done by programming, because it is not possible to calculate it manually, and the complete analysis of mechanical mechanism also can be incorporated using the programming. So this is overall syllabus we are going to study in this subject. So now if we see the GATE syllabus, the paper code is ME, that is mechanical engineering, and in section 2, which is applied mechanics and design, you can see the major areas as engineering mechanics of material, theory of machines, vibrations and design engineering or machine design. So these are five main topics included in section 2. If you concern with the theory of machine, there will be minimum 2 to 3 questions will be asked, which includes basically displacement and velocity acceleration analysis of plane mechanism. There will be definitely one question on degrees of freedom will be asked in this section. Then there will be question on cams of gear and gear trains, flywheels and governors, balancing of reciprocating rotating masses and gyroscope, which you might have studied in term 2, or you will study in term 1. You might have studied in term 1, but if not, you will be studying in term 2. So basically, as far as the analysis and synthesis of mechanism is concerned, these the points which are highlighted in red color are important and which we are going to study. So GATE for the year of 2021 has been announced by the IITs, and which will be held by or organized by the IIT Bombay. The dates of examination are 5th, 6th, 7th, 12th, 13th and 14th February 2021. Now I would like to tell you the eligibility criteria has been modified for GATE 2021. Which says that a candidate who is currently studying in third or higher years of any undergraduate degree, or has already completed the degree from government approved college or institutes in engineering, technology, architecture, science and commerce arts, can be applied for this particular examination. So that means third year students also can apply for GATE from the year 2021. So the official website is given here. You can find the previous year question papers on the link which is stated here. Basically, the GATE examination will be held for 100 marks. Each paper will carry total marks of 100. There will be common general aptitude section for 15 marks, and main paper, that is mechanical engineering paper and mathematics, some of the mathematical contents will be there for 85 marks. The verbal ability and numerical ability contents are given here for your reference. You can go through it. Now, the reference book for these subjects are the book by Design of Machinery by Norton, which is published by Tata McGraw-Hill Publication. Then you can refer to the very nice book which is written by IIT professor, that is Amitva Ghosh and A.K. Malik. The name of book is Theory of Machines and Mechanism, which is published by East West Press from the New Delhi. This is very nice book actually, which is written by two professors, that is Ghosh and Malik from IIT Kanpur. And some of the NPTEL lectures are also available on YouTube. Then the third book is by Edmund and Sandor, which is Mechanism Design and Synthesis and Analysis, splitted in volume 1 and 2 by Patience Hall Publications India. Last book you can refer is by V.P. Singh, that is Theory of Machines by Dasgupta Rai and Publications. So the course outcomes are, at the end of the course, student will be able to analyze various existing mechanisms, design an analysis of extensive range of mechanisms by model based learning or project based learning. You'll be able to simulate and verify the performance of design mechanism. That means you will be able to compare the results of simulation and results from the experimentation which you are going to analyze from actual model. And last but not the least is you will be able to develop the working prototype for different mechanisms. Now let us start with the introduction to this subject. Now as the name of subject includes basically three names, as analysis and synthesis of mechanism, we must understand what is a mechanism is. Now you can see here one mechanism is shown and the animation shown, which is basically nothing but a power shovel, which is nothing but a bucket equipped machine, or it is kind of earth moving equipment, usually electrically powered and used for digging and loading earth or like a fragmented rocks, or even for the mineral extraction. So now when we look at this particular mechanism, what should we understand? Now let us try to find out the links first. I can see one link here, which can be called as a crank, input crank, which is turning around this center B. Then you can observe the link B0 to C2, which can be considered as a coupler, which is also turning according to the motion of this particular input crank. And then you can see the link which is C2 A0, which can be considered as a rack, which is engaged with the pinion, which is centered at A. So if you measure the number of links in this particular mechanism, let us measure it now. The fixed link will be this one, where the center A and center B are located. So this will be link number one, fixed link. Crank will be second link, coupler will be third link, this rack will be fourth link, and this pinion will be fifth link. So we can call this mechanism as five link mechanism, a mechanism which consists of five links. Now this is the first observation. Now second observation, we will try to find out the joints. The fixed link and crank makes first joint, the crank and this coupler makes the second joint, the coupler and rack makes the further joint. Now if you see the joint between this rack and a pinion, it is kind of higher pair. So it, because the first three joints which we saw were the lower pairs because there was area contact or surface contact. But if you see this joint, like the joint between rack and pinion, it is kind of a line, line contact, or we can say a point contact. Hence, this can be considered as a higher pair. So this will be higher pair, and again this pair of pinion and fixed link form a lower pair. So these are pairs which we have found out. Now let us try to understand the motions. Now link number first and second, like first link is fixed, second link is crank, which has a turning motion. Then the link like input crank and this particular coupler is also having a turning motion. But now if you see the motion of this particular rack, you will be able to find that this rack is turning also. Along with turning, it is sliding along this pinion. So the basically, as we know, that rack and pinion mechanism is used to convert linear motion into rotary motion, or rotary motion into linear motion, vice versa. So if we see here, this slider, this rack is sliding also and it is turning also. So that is why this mechanism consists of five different linkages. And then again, if you see the motion between pinion and the fixed link, it is turning kind of motion. So now if you would like to define a mechanism using two different approaches, what we will do is we will define the mechanism using functional approach and then using a motion approach, or we can say using a constructional approach. So basically there are two approaches. So what we will be summarizing from this example, that if a number of bodies or linkages are assembled in such a way that the motion of one causes constrained and predictable motion of others. So what does it mean that motion of one, that is motion of any one link, which is input link, causes constrained and predictable motion of others? That means turning motion of this particular input crank causes constrained and predictable motion of coupler, then the rack and a pinion. So that means what is meaning of constraints? Constraint is a predefined, or it is called as with some boundaries or with some limitations. So as we know that to trace this particular coupler curve, which is ultimate output of this mechanism, we need to have motion of coupler as turning motion, motion of the rack as sliding and turning motion. Hence it is called as constraint, and it is predictable also, because when the crank is rotating along this center or turning along this center, we will be able to predict what will be the motion of coupler, what will be the motion of the rack, and what will be the motion of pinion. That is why it is called as motion of one link causes, or input link causes, constrained and predictable motion of others. So it is called as mechanism. So this definition is considered to be functional definition of mechanism. But if you would like to define your mechanism according to its construction, then what we will define it as, if one of the link of the kinematic chain is fixed, this is usual definition, you people have studied in theory of machines. So if any one link from the kinematic chain is fixed, then it is called as a mechanism. So I'll summarize it again. Mechanism is nothing but assembly of number of kinematic links. If one of the links of kinematic chain is fixed, it will act as a mechanism in such a way that it should transmit a motion. But not only it transmits the motion, but also it modifies the motion. That means the motion of this particular turning of crank and coupler will be modified as motion of this rack as it is sliding. So that is why it just not transmit the motion, but also it modifies the motion of the other linkages. Now if we compare the mechanism with machine, a combination of mechanisms would be called as machine. But the main difference is it not only imparts the definite motion of the parts, but also transmits and modifies the available mechanical energy into some kind of desirable work. So this is basic difference between machine and mechanism. Now we have understood what is mechanism. Now remaining two words is what is analysis and what is synthesis. Now, analysis is nothing but the study of motions and the study of forces for different parts or different linkages of existing mechanism. On the other hand, synthesis involves the calculation of dimensions of different parts. That means dimensions of a crank or a coupler or output crank will be calculated according to the empirical relations or some laws which we are going to study in the next section, further sections. So in mechanism, the various parts are so proportioned that they related to that motion of one imparts the requisite motion of others, which we have seen in the previous slide, and the parts are able to withstand the forces impressed upon them. So synthesis is nothing but the study of relative motions that does not depend. So basically synthesis is nothing but study of relative motions of different parts of a mechanism, which really does not depend on the strength and the actual shape of the parts. Now we will try to justify this statement by using some example. Now if you take the example of reciprocating engine, the displacement of this piston is depends on the length of connecting rod and crank. Now why is it written like that? Because if you would like to find out the stroke of this particular piston or displacement of this particular piston, the empirical relation is stated as stroke is equal to twice the length of this particular crank. So that means if you want to synthesize your mechanism or try to find out the dimensions of your mechanism, there is no need of by considering the material of that particular part or shape of that particular part, because standard crank, standard connecting rod, standard piston is it will be a standardized relationship. So if you know that if just stroke consists of the empirical relation and it is given by formula that it should be twice of length of a crank, then it is sufficient. Then there is no need of going for which material of it is made up of, or what is the shape of that particular thing. So analysis and synthesis of mechanism only deals with finding out the empirical finding out the dimension of various links using empirical relation. So that is why it is called as it is independent of bearing strength of various parts or whether they are able to withstand the forces or not. Thus the study of motions, it is immaterial of if a machine part is made up of mild steel, cast iron or wood, any kind of material. So also it is not necessary to know the actual shape and area of cross section of the material or that particular part. Thus the study of motion of different parts of mechanism, the study of forces is not necessary, hence it can be neglected. Now the various branches of the mechanics, you people are already aware of this, but I would like to define this with respect to our subject. So kinematic deals with the relative motion of different parts of mechanism without taking consideration of forces producing those motions. Thus it is study from the geometric point of view and to know the displacement, velocity and acceleration of a part of mechanism. So we are going to deal with kinematics in the subject of analysis and synthesis of mechanism, because we are going to study the geometric point of view, the motion of that particular mechanism, and hence it is included in the kinematics. Dynamics involves the calculation of forces impressed upon different parts of mechanism, and the forces can be either static or dynamic. So kinetics is nothing but study of forces when body is in motion, and static is nothing but it deals with the forces when the body is stationary. So this is basic difference between kinetics and statics. Now let us try to study what is degrees of freedom. When we call any kind of mechanism, or when we would like to study any kind of mechanism, there is always necessity to find out degrees of freedom. So the degrees of freedom can be defined using various ways. It is many time it is called as mobility also. Unconstrained rigid body moving in space can describe the following independent motion, that is translation motion along the three mutually perpendicular axes, that is x, y and z, and rotational motion about these axes, that is by either clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. So a rigid body possesses 6 degrees of freedom when it is assumed to be kept in a space. So this picture will explain it is a schematic which explains the meaning of translation motion and rotational motion. So translation movement in three perpendicular axes can be seen here, the moving forward and backward, moving up and down, and moving left and right. So first we will see moving forward and backward. So we can see forward and backward can be visualized from the arrow which is shown in the blue color. So this can be said as forward, this will be backward, then this will be considered to be the downward, this will be upward, and then one will be at right and another one will be at left. So basically it is called as surge, heave and sway. Now if we go to the rotational movement about three perpendicular axes, we can see here roll can be considered as tilting side to side, pitch will be considered as tilting forward and backward, and yaw will be considered to be the turning left and right. So tilting side by side can be seen using this particular arrow. Pitch can be seen using this particular arrow, and yaw will be seen using this particular arrow. So by combining these three and these three degrees of freedom, you get total number of degrees of freedom as 6, which is shown in this third picture. So basically the connection of a link with another, connection of one link to another, imposes certain constraints on their relative motion. The number of restraints can never be zero, as joint is disconnected, or it cannot be 6, because then joint will be a solid and it becomes a structure. What is meaning of restrain? It is nothing but a condition that keeps someone or something under control. So that means if let us consider two links which are not connected to each other, then the link, first link, if it is kept in a space, it will have 6 degrees of freedom. Now if you connect another link to the first link at one point, automatically this restrain, this condition which is controlling the motion of first and second link, will always reduce the degrees of freedom. That is what is meaning of the sentence which is written here. So degrees of freedom of a pair is defined as number of independent relative motions, both translational and rotational, a pair can have. So as we have studied that maximum number of degrees of freedom of a mechanism which is kept in space will have a 6 degrees of freedom. So to calculate degrees of freedom, you must consider that degrees of freedom is equal to 6, which is maximum degrees of freedom minus number of restraints, because number of restraint, as you go on adding, the degree of freedom will get reduced. That is why this formula is formulated, the model. Now to determine the degree of freedom, we need to express the number of degrees of freedom of a link in terms of number of links and the number of pair of connections for different types. It is called as number synthesis. So let us consider that the N, capital N, will be total number of links in a mechanism. Capital F will be degrees of freedom. P1 will be number of pairs with which having 1 degree of freedom, which are considered to be always lower pairs. And P2 will be considered as pair which are having 2 degrees of freedom, which are considered to be higher pair. If some pairs are having degrees of freedom as 3, 4 and 5, then it will be considered as P3, P4 and P5. So as we know that in mechanism one link is fixed, so automatically movable links will be equal to number of links minus 1, because fixed link is not moving, that is why it has to be subtracted from total number of links. That is why it is written as number of movable links must be equal to capital N, that is total number of links minus 1. Minus 1 is done because one link has to be fixed to make it as a mechanism. So number of degrees of freedom for those particular links which are moving will be obviously calculated as if it is kept in a space, then number of degrees of freedom for each movable link will be calculated as multiplying that particular number with 6. So 6 into n minus 1 will give you total number of degrees of freedom for each movable link. Now each pair having 1 degree of freedom imposes 5 restraints on the mechanism, hence reducing the degrees of freedom by 5 into P1. Similarly, each pair having 2 degrees of freedom will impose 4 restraints, reducing the degrees of freedom of mechanism by 4 into P2. Now if you see what is meaning of this statement, if we consider a 4 bar mechanism and link number fixed link and the crank, then of course when you connect the fixed link and crank, the degrees of freedom of crank when it is kept in a space without connecting to any other link will be 6. But if it is connected to fixed link, then automatically it imposed five restraints. That is why it is called as each pair having one degree of freedom imposes five restraints on a mechanism. That means reducing the degrees of freedom for that particular link by 5 into P1. Similarly, other pairs having 3, 4 and 5 degrees of freedom will obviously reduce the degrees of freedom in that sense. So, now formula for calculating degrees of freedom for a mechanism which are placed in space is considered to be 6F, that is degrees of freedom is equal to 6 into N minus 1. The meaning of this particular term is that N minus 1 is nothing but number of movable links into 6 degrees of freedom for all links, and according to constraints or restraints we will reduce the number of degrees of freedom. So if your mechanism is consist of P1 number of pairs, then it must be multiplied by 5 and it should be subtracted from this particular term. Similarly, for P2 it should be multiplied by 4 as we have seen here. Then P3 will be multiplied by 3 because each pair which possesses 3 degrees of freedom will impose 3 restraints. Similarly, 4 degrees of pair will impose 2 restraints and 5 degrees of freedom will impose a single restraint. That is why only it is subtracted as minus. Okay, so now let us try to understand the meaning of this statement using one example. Each pair having 1 degree of freedom imposes 5 restraints on the mechanism, reducing its degrees of freedom by 5, that is 5 into P1, where P1 is pair which is having 1 degree of freedom. Now let us take one example. If you consider this crank named as AB, which is shown here by line diagram with end A and with end B, which is input crank. Now suppose this crank now is placed in space with the all three axes, that means it should have 6 degrees of freedom. That means this AB crank can move in this direction or in this direction or in this direction, or in upward or in downward. So that means this input crank will possess all three translational motion, that is heave, sway and surge. Now since both ends are free, it will also possess rolling, yawing and pitching. So let us try to see this. It is rolling, we can say. If you would like to see the yawing, it can be like this. Now since it is shown in 2 degrees of freedom and like 2 planes itself, I am not able to show it exactly, but you try to understand. And then you can see pitching like this in these 2 planes. So obviously this particular link will possess all 6 degrees of freedom. Now it is said that each pair having 1 degree of freedom imposes 5 restraints on mechanism. So that means now we will consider a fixed link which is shown here, and now what we will do, we will connect this link AB to the fixed link at point A, and now we will try to find out the degrees of freedom. Now you just tell me, is it possible for this AB link to move in this direction or in this direction, or in upward direction or in downward direction, or in sway? No. So that means 3 degrees of freedom by translational motion are eliminated. Now what is remaining? Now just try to correlate this particular diagram with this crank. That means pitching and yawing is also not possible because A is fixed at this particular point, so only turning or rolling will be possible. So that means only 1 degree of freedom will be possessed by this link AB. So that means degrees of freedom of this link AB is reduced by 5 That is why it should be multiplied with 5 into P1. Have you understood it now? I hope you have understood. So now let us try to understand what is meaning of this statement. Each pair having 2 degrees of freedom will impose 4 restraints, reducing degrees of freedom of mechanism by 4 into P2. Now let us take one example. A link or a pair which consists of 2 degrees of freedom. Now as you all know that the pair which is formed by this pinion and this rack is higher pair because it possesses line contact or point contact, hence this to be considered as higher pair. As we all know that a single higher pair possesses 2 degrees of freedom. So let us consider this linkage or we can say pair with 2 degrees of freedom. Now if you would like to visualize this 2 degrees of freedom, you can see here this rack is sliding along this axis. Along with that it is turning with this direction also. So what we can see is this pair is sliding also and it is turning also. But now since this mechanism is considered to be a planar mechanism, we know that maximum degrees of freedom is 3. So that means already 2 degrees of freedom are there here in this pair. So obviously degrees of freedom for this particular, because of this particular pair, will be reduced by obviously 1. So that means 3 minus 1 into P2 is to be incorporated here, because 2 degrees of freedom sliding and turning has been already incorporated. Only 1 degrees of freedom is to be reduced because it is not possible. Remaining 1 degree of freedom, it is not possible because already 2 degrees of freedom are considered. Hence it is to be 1 into P2 is to be eliminated from the formula of degrees of freedom. This statement is written for spatial mechanism. That means a mechanism which is located in a space with 6 degrees of freedom. So obviously for 6 degrees of freedom, when it includes 2 degrees of freedom, how many degrees of freedom are remaining? 4. So that means degrees of freedom, total number of degrees of freedom must be reduced by 4. That is why 4 into P2 has been multiplied. And that is why only it is subtracted as minus P5. But if we consider this particular formula, a generalized formula, it would be considered for only mechanisms which are kept in a space. So this above criteria is hardly necessary to find out degrees of freedom. A space mechanism, especially of zero order, are not practical. As we know that zero order mechanism are just impractical because it is assumed that it includes the all 6 degrees of freedom and it is imposing zero restraints. So most of the mechanisms are two dimensional, such as 4 bar or slider crank mechanisms, in which displacement is possible along only two axes, that is one restraint, and rotation about only one axis, that is two instant it will impose. Thus there are 3 general restraints when we are considering a mechanism which is placed in 2 planes. Therefore for planar mechanism, the following relation may be used to find out degrees of freedom. So here the terms of P3, P4 and P5 are eliminated because a mechanism which is kept in 2 axes will possess only maximum degrees of freedom is equal to 3. So there is no question of adding these 3 terms, isn't it? So only it is written as F is equal to 3, as it is kept in 2 planes, number of maximum degrees of freedom will be equal to 3. Hence movable links multiplied by number of degrees of freedom will give you this particular term, and then it is subtracted by 2 into P1, that is lower pairs which impose 2 restraints, and higher pair P2 which impose the single restraint. So now if you consider this particular formula, it is called as Gruberell criteria for calculating degrees of freedom for a mechanism which is kept in 2 planes or 2 axes, in which each movable link possesses. So each pair with 1 degree of freedom imposes 2 further restraints on the mechanism, thus reducing the degrees of freedom, as we have already studied. Similarly, each pair with 2 degree of freedom reduces the degrees of freedom of mechanism at the rate of 1 restraint each. So some author mentioned the above relation as Cuthbert criteria and simplified that relationship as F is equal to 3 into n minus 1 minus 2 into P1. So if you see here P2 term, the term of higher pair is excluded. That means it is applicable to linkages with only single degree of freedom in the Grubler's criteria. Thus, for linkages with single degree of freedom will be considered as P2. So P2 will be equal to 0. So most of the linkages are expected to have 1 degree of freedom, so that one input of any link, a constrained motion of other is obtained. So it is assumed that degrees of freedom will be equal to 1. So instead of F, now we will put it as 1 is equal to 3 n minus 1 minus 2 P1. If we simplify this particular equation, we get it in the form that 1 is equal to 3 into n minus 3, that is 3 into n minus 3 into 1, that is 3 minus 2 P1. So take this 2 P1 on the left hand side and 1 on the right hand side, so you get 2 P1 is equal to 3 n minus 3 minus 1, so minus 3 minus 1 you get minus 4. And final formula, if you can see here, it is nothing but 2P1 is equal to 3N minus 4. So as P and N are to be whole numbers, the relation can be satisfied only if N and V, number of links, it should be even. So this was about calculating degrees of freedom in the space with the planar mechanism, using Grubler criteria, Cuthbert criteria and so on. From the next lecture, we'll be try to solve some of the numericals based on calculating degrees of freedom, and then we will go for the detailed synthesis and analysis of four bar mechanism and slider tank mechanism. Thank you so much. I just hope that you will be able to correlate what we have studied in this session with respect to, you know, the mechanisms or any kind of machines which are available at your circumstances, and try to correlate what we have studied in this current section. Thank you so much.